The UCC28056 is a 6-pin single-phase transition mode PFC controller that has met the challenge of meeting all the stringent energy standards like Energy Star 80+, COC Tier 2, EOP Lot 6, and DOE Level 6. At full load, UCC28056 operates the PFC in transition mode, also known as critical conduction mode. When the load reduces, it transits seamlessly into discontinuous conduction mode to minimize the switch loss. If the load is further reduced, it enters into burst mode to further reduce the switch loss and improve light load efficiency. It not only achieves ultra-low standby power, outstanding light load efficiency, but also provides excellent THD and power factor. This device is available at the TI store at ti.com/product/UCC28056. Hello everyone, my name is Bo Shensun. Today, I'm going to demonstrate a PFC evaluation module controlled by this device, UCC28056. Here is a PFC UEM controlled by UCC28056. It accepts universal AC input from 85 volts to 265 volts, with output of 390 volts and a full load output power of 160 watts. From left to right, you can see the AC input collector, EMI filter, bridge rectifier, PFC inductor, PFC switch, diode, PFC output cap, and PFC output voltage collector. There is also a bias voltage collector to provide VCC to UCC28056. The UCC28056 is on the bottom side. To power up this EVM, you will need an isolated AC source, an isolated DC source with output of 12 volts or higher, and a high voltage load. Make sure both the AC and DC source output are off before you connect them to the UEM. Now let's connect the AC input to J1, connect the DC input to J8, and connect load to J9. To check the PFC waveform, use one current probe to measure PFC input current. Use another current probe to measure PFC inductor current. And use a differential probe to measure the switch load voltage. Since this is the high voltage converter, it is critical that you do not touch the board once it is powered on to avoid any accidents. Now let's look at the power up sequence. First, set the load between 0 amps to 0.42 amps, then turn on the load. Secondly, set the AC between 85 volts to 265 volts, and then turn on the AC. Lastly, set the DC to be 12 volts and then turn on the DC. Now you can see that the PFC generates an output at about 390 volts. On the scope, you can also see the PFC input current waveform. Let's run the PFC at heavy load and zoom in the waveform. The yellow is the switch load voltage, the green is the inductor current. It shows clearly that the switch turns on when the inductor current drops to zero. The PFC is operating at transition mode. Let's reduce the load. Now you can see that the PFC enters the DCM mode. Also, the switch turns on when the switch load voltage is at its valley. The DCM and valley switching reduce the switch loss. Finally, let's see what happens when you further reduce the load. You can see that the PFC enters into burst mode at light load. The switch loss is further reduced. Powering off is very simple. Turn off AC, turn off DC, turn off load, then disconnect everything. Now you know how to get started with the UCC28056 UEM. For more information about our new PFC controller UCC28056 and this EVM, please visit ti.com/product/UCC28056. Thanks for watching.